Hey everyone, it's Kelsey again.
Hey everyone, it's Kelsey again.
We're here for another episode of Level Up the Geek.
Ba, 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 level up.
So tomorrow is tabletop day and we are really, really excited.
We pause for a minute because I'm gonna go potty. But don't forget me.
So Harrison's taking a quick bathroom break. So while he's there, I just want to say that we're really excited because tomorrow is International Tabletop Day. We look forward to Tabletop Day every year because we love playing games. If you're not familiar with what Tabletop Day is or what it involves, I'll put a link down in the description below so that you can check it out. So as tempting as it might be to drop Harrison off at a babysitter's house or a family member's house for the day so that we can just play games with our friends all day, that's kind of missing the point of what Tabletop Day is all about. See, to me, Tabletop Day is about getting together with friends and family and having a great time, learning new games, having fun together, and just enjoying ourselves as a family. So, how exactly does one include someone so little in Tabletop Day when there's not a lot of games out there for kids? Oh, here's Harrison now. Find games they like to play, of course. Now, I don't know about you, but I get kind of sick of playing Candyland, Chutes and Ladders. Those games just really aren't very fun to me. So I'm always on a constant quest to find good games for little kids to enjoy that I actually also enjoy playing as well. It's not an easy task to do, but it's definitely doable, and there's a lot of great games out there anymore for kids Harrison's age and a little bit older, and even a little bit younger. Here's some of our favorites. We really enjoy the game Gathering the Garden.
And this is really fun to play, and what you do in this game is take whatever you want to take from our other garden to your garden.
Can you tell us a little bit about another favorite, Hoot Owl Hoot?
You get to your nest.
Another one of our favorite games, this one is called Hiss.
On this game, you have to match your colors and at the end, you get a rainbow snake tail.
So, is this your favorite game, Harrison?
Mm-hmm.
This is my favorite game, too. That's a kid's game. Robot Turtles. They call it the game for little programmers, and it's amazing. If you haven't seen it,
I'm going to show you.
You should check it out. What's Robot Turtles about?
Robot Turtles is about you go and raise an icebox, and you get your jewel.
So check out our recent game of Robot Turtles to get you excited for tomorrow's International Tabletop Day as a family. Robot Turtles is a pretty simple game, and it seems like kids find it quite easy to pick up on once they've played for a bit. The game comes with 4 turtle tokens, 4 color corresponding jewel tokens, 4 bug tokens, a set of various obstacle cards, these are optional, and sets of direction cards for each turtle: front, right turn, left turn, laser, and function. Once you have removed all cats from your board, you're ready to play. Each player places their turtle card on its designated starting spot and the corresponding colored jewel in the center of the board. The object of the game is to get your robot turtle to its jewel as quickly as possible by using the direction cards to guide your turtle along its path. An optional additional challenge is created by placing various obstacle cards around the board, such as ice that must be melted with the turtle's laser, or boxes that the turtles must move around. I don't think we ever really use these quite correctly, but Harrison loves having them on the board and setting them up, so we have our own sets of rules surrounding these objects. There is also an optional function scenario that we have not introduced yet to Harrison, but will introduce once he's ready for the added complexity. One thing we love about this game is that it grows with him. When we first started playing, he never used obstacles and the game was very straightforward. The more he plays and the older he gets, the more complex he is able to comprehend and work within the game. Harrison often makes mistakes in which direction he wants his turtle to go. When this happens, we try to coach him through the problem. You may notice that the direction cards correspond with the color of a flower on the turtle card to indicate which way the turtle would move to if that color direction card is played. If he still completes an action and then is frustrated that his turtle does not move as expected, he is able to use his bug card, which lets him undo any action. As you can see, much of this game is introductory logic and programming. Without realizing it, Harrison is learning to guide a program by simple commands and stringing together a line of code in the form of logical reasoning. We leave our played cards in front of us so that at the end of the game, we're able to see the entire line of code that we created for our turtles. It amazes me to see Harrison's logical thinking emerge, and the game mechanics and design are just really well done.
This game is awesome. I'm gonna play it all day long.
What's your favorite part about Robot Turtles?
You raise it.
Do you have any other favorite parts?
Reveals.
What do you think the game teaches you, Harrison?
It raises my eyes. So let's go ahead and play some games.
Great idea. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button if you like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel because we have lots of great videos coming your way soon. And as always, stay geeky and play more games. And then one of our most favorite games. Let me go get that one, okay?
Okay, so I'm gonna tell my line. This game is awesome. I'm gonna play it all day